Hello student, welcome to your PDI education. So in this video I'm going to discuss with you people the preparation strategy and how actually you need to prepare for HPCL and IOCL interview. The strategy is very common to both PSUs. First I will discuss the general point, then I will go for the technical subject. Let me brief first. The motive of this video is how in different way and how your approach should be different while preparing for interview rather than doing preparation for some written or gate exam. There is a huge difference. Okay, obviously the concept and logic, they will remain identical whether you are preparing for interview and whether you are preparing for written test, but the approach matters and it has a lot effect on your preparation strategy. Keep in mind. Fine. So in interview there are the three aspects which are mainly covered for all sort of the aspirant, whether they are fresher or whether they are working experience fellow. The very first is project and work experience. This project mostly for the fresher student, and if you are a working fellow then work experience, then internship, industrial training, and then finally the technical subject. So if you are going after some work experience, then you must be really well aware of what were your role and responsibility. You must be well explaining that effectively, and what are the tools and technology you have deal with in your past organization, and what is your biggest learning from the past work experience, and what changes you feel in your personality after that learning experience. Is it okay? Second thing is that if you are a fresher candidate, then they ask more about your project. Now what sort of the question they ask about project? The very first is the objective of project, and keep in mind you must be able or efficient to convey your objective in very brief, in short span of time, because they don't allow much time. और एक चीज़ का ध्यान रखना, बस बताते वक्त बोर मत करना, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ है. द सेकेंड थिंग इज एब्स्ट्रैक्ट और एक्सपेरिमेंटल स्टडी ऑफ योर प्रोजेक्ट विच इंक्लूड यू नो जनरल आर्किटेक्चर एंड व्हाट वर द प्रिंसिपल एंड कंपैरिजन एंड कॉन्सेप्ट इन्वॉल्व इन अ प्रोजेक्ट. द थर्ड वन इज व्हाट वॉज योर रोल एंड कंट्रीब्यूशन, बिकॉज यूजुअली प्रोजेक्ट इज डन बाय द यू नो 4 and 5 स्टूडेंट. सो इन व्हाट पार्ट एक्चुअली यू वर इन्वॉल्व इन टू डिस्कस विद अस दैट, सो दैट दे कैन आस्क क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दैट पार्ट ओनली. So here you need to be very smart. Okay, you need to mention that part which you think you can explain beautifully, and you are well efficient to explain that part. The fourth thing is what are the result and conclusion of your project. That is very must part. And the fifth, sometimes they play very tricky questions, that what are the cost of the component which were involved in your project. This question they ask, reason being they are aware that most of the time student purchase some of the project from market and just prepare from the Google for the interview point of view. That is why they ask this tricky question. So whatever project you have prepared or whether you have purchased it, just be well aware of what were the cost of individual component, and if your project include various hardware module, what were their rating, current voltage rating, were the component active or passive, and if there were some communicating module, then what were their range and which type of module and which type of communication they allow, series or parallel communication. Again, next question from project, if your project involve microcontroller and sensors and you belong from instrumentation, then lot of question you can expect from there. The question related to microprocessor will be asked only if it is involved in your project. Architecture of that microcontroller, why you choose that microcontroller, about its clock frequency and about the application of microcontroller. Is it clear? And sometimes they ask question how this microcontroller is different from the controller we use in the control system. Can we use this microcontroller there? These sort of the question they generally ask. In sensor, whether it was active or passive, about its time response, about its frequency response. What are the practical example, other you know analogous sensors related to this technology, then about linearity of the sensor, about the sensitivity of the sensor, sometimes they ask question. So these are the all aspect you need to cover in your major project. So first step is complete this beautifully. The second thing is internship and industrial training. Whether you have done in design, automation, transmission and distribution, hydropower plant or solar power plant, you must be able to explain in short time again what was your learning in that short interval of time, whether you have done for 1 month, 2 month or 6 month. Doesn't matter योर लर्निंग शुड बी वेरी लार्ज. अगर आपने थोड़ा बहुत भी सीखा है बट अगर आप इफेक्टिवली उसको कम्युनिकेट कर पाए, उनको रिप्रेजेंट कर पाए, तो आपने अपना टास्क सॉल्व कर दिया है रिलेटेड टू दिस इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रेनिंग एंड इंटर्नशिप. इज इट क्लियर? द थर्ड थिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट इज टेक्निकल सब्जेक्ट. सी नाउ आई विल से इफ यू बिलोंग टू इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन और इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल कैटेगराइज द सब्जेक्ट. वॉट इज दैट कैटेगराइजेशन? दैट कैटेगराइजेशन इज आई विल से, लेट अस से, दीज आर द बेसिक इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट. वॉट आर द बेसिक इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट? टेल मी योर बेसिक इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट्स आर यू नो सर्किट एनालिसिस, देन यू हैव डिजिटल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, देन यू हैव सिग्नल एंड सिस्टम, देन यू हैव कंट्रोल सिस्टम, राइट? दे विल आस्क यू वॉट आर द सब्जेक्ट यू आर कंफर्टेबल विद. सो इफ दे आस्क यू दिस क्वेश्चन, at least you need to mention four subject, not more than that. If they are not satisfied the subject which you have tell, they will ask you more subject, then you can add any other subject. First tell those four subject in which you think you are really comfortable with, right? Don't say sir I am comfortable with a subject, that is a wrong impression. Now how those four subjects should be, you know, integrated, any of two your core subject or any of two your basic engineering subject. So for instrumentation student, I will suggest better go with these two, digital electronic, signal system. Why I am leaving this control system? Because this will be integrated with your process control. They will ask combined question, they will not ask individual question from control system. This is your one major subject. Second thing is industrial instrumentation. Industrial instrumentation. So this is the list of four subjects: digital electronics, signal system, and then this process control, control system, and industrial instrumentation. Then one more subject I will add here, that is analog electronics. Analog electronics, and in analog electronics specifically I will say only op amp part. For instrumentation student I am saying only, not other part. Along with op amp oscillator, just what is Barkhausen criteria? So this is the part you need to focus. It doesn't mean that you don't need to have, you know, prepare circuit analysis, you don't need to prepare any other subject. No. See, when I say prepare any four subject, those four subject you need to prepare in well detail, in more detail, you know, what you have prepared for the written exam. You might having your notes which you have made for the written test, for all the subject revise those notes once. But for these four subject, industrial instrumentation, process control, digital electronics, signal system, give some more focus. In what direction? In industrial instrumentation, you must be well aware of basically flow control mechanism. You must be well aware of basically, you know, level control. You must be well aware of basically temperature control. How the control mechanism work here, what are the different type of the sensor involved, the comparison of those sensors on the basis of linearity, accuracy and range. Apart from that, you know, why we do the instrument calibrations, questions about controller tuning. So these are the domain you need to compare, you need to prepare in well. Apart from that, the questions about precision, accuracy, the static parameter which we called, hysteresis and sensitivity of the sensors or any of the instruments, keep in mind. So these are the topic you need to prepare in well detail. Now if I ask about digital electronics, in digital electronics their more focus will be on the data conversion technique, A to D, D to A. What are the different type of converter available, the comparison of those converter on the basis of speed, conversion time, accuracy, settling time. What are the specification parameter of any data converter? And what are the different stages of the data converter, sampler, quantizer, encoder, these all things. Serial communication, parallel data communication. How we can convert from serial to parallel, parallel to serial. Second thing, you know, in instrumentation, we are dealing with control and monitoring of the processes. For controlling and monitoring, the very basic thing is indicator. how to design indicator or alarming circuit by making the use of logic gates. Very common question they ask, pressure indicator, temperature indicator. So there you must be knowing how effectively you can use the logic gate. They are not going to ask you draw the truth table of AND gate, NOT gate. No. How effectively you can use the functionality of that logic gate to generate the alarm, to make the indicating circuit, to make the monitoring and controlling circuit. That is very important. And apart from that, which you have not prepared for written, that is sample and hold circuit and about its blocks. Data acquisition system, really very important. Question on duty cycle, how we can generate clock, different clock generator methods. So these are the topic you need to prepare really well. Keep in mind in digital electronics. Apart from that, which we have prepared for written. In signal and system, the one topic very important, that is sampling. How you convert data from time domain to frequency domain. Why both time domain and frequency domain analysis are important. What are the different type of bandwidth we study? Absolute bandwidth, 3 dB bandwidth, what are the comparisons? Then can we replace Laplace transform with Fourier transform? If yes, then why? If not, then why? Difference between Fourier transform, Z transform, Laplace transform. They all are the transform domain, then why different? These sort of the question they ask. And some more question on LTI system, which are characterized in terms of the impulse response that you have studied in the basic gate as well as. If you have prepared really well for gate, then those you are comfortable with. Apart from that, question about operational amplifier, how you can generate application specific circuit by using the op-amp, instrumentation amplifier, integrator, differentiator, how you can use this for the function generator operation, signal generator operations. So you need to be well aware of both linear and non-linear application of operational amplifier. Then we talk about this process control and control system. There you need to prepare in practical sense. They can ask you general question, okay, we want to control the temperature inside the house at 20 degrees Celsius. Draw a control system. What will be the plant? What will be the actuator? What will be the controller used? Give us example. What will be the internal and external disturbances? What will be the set point? What will be the input to the plant? Tell me the variable. These sort of the question they ask. So you need to prepare in that directions. Then they can ask you question, you know, draw any position control system. And in position control system, if I vary the gain of the controller, then how the output response will vary with the time? In this direction, apart from that, what you have prepared for the written, you need to prepare. And the third very important, controllers, whether it is proportional, PD, PI or PID. The first about controller tuning. Second, in controller, while answering the question, you need to keep three things in mind. Which mode of controller? Proportional, proportional integral, proportional derivative, PID. For which function? To increase the gain, to reduce the, you know, offset, to reduce the overshoot, to speed up the response, and in what applications? Where load changes slowly, where set point changes abruptly, these sort of the questions they ask. And some question about actuator, difference between actuator and sensor, valve and damper. So this is the only part you need to control, you need to cover in control system. And one more thing, stability, which is the basic topic. Fine. So I will suggest for instrumentation student, be well prepared with four topics. I told you signal system, digital electronics, control system, process control, I written combinedly, then industrial instrumentation. And one more topic, that is fiber optics. I'm writing here. Fiber optic sensing. Fiber optic sensing. Here they will discuss with you what are the various losses associated with the optical fiber, the comparison of optical fiber with the other communication media, what are the different, you know, principle, working principle of the optical fiber and any multiplexing technique available in the optical fiber, general question based on the construction of optical fibers. So these are the topic any instrumentation engineer should prepare and in what way, as I discussed here. Fine. Now, let us move about electrical engineering. In electrical engineering, apart from the basic engineering, we have subject machine for electrical engineering. Apart from basic engineering, then we have power system. Then we have power electronics.
right?
Now again, if you are really good in circuit analysis, only then you are good at the power electronics and power system and machine. And one more thing, for electrical fellow, you must be really well aware of electromagnetics behind the machine. Electromagnetics, you must be really good at electromagnetics. It is not in syllabus, but much needed for interview. So please refer 12th class physics if you can refer, especially for the part of electrostatics and magnetostatics and various physics fundamental laws. 100% they are going to ask question from here on the basic level. Apart from this, what should be the topic you need to prepare here? Transformer. The very important and go-to topic of any interview. In transformers, sir, what type of question? Usually we know, we are interested in giving sinusoidal input to the transformer. And we have made all the conclusion on that basis. He asked if you give square input, triangular wave input to the transformer, what will happen? Can you draw the primary current versus induced EMF curve? Will there be any lead and lag? How to represent phase lead and phase lag for the non-sinusoidal input? So prepare in that direction. What is the condition for maximum efficiency? What are the different type of losses associated with the transformer, major losses and minor losses? How we can minimize those? Question about transformer core, its shape and cross section. What is the material used? Question about transformer winding. And question about, you know, its efficiency. And question about, you know, what are the assumptions we had made when we assume idle transformer? Many questions about parallel operation of the transformer. Why parallel operation of the transformer is preferred? What should be the constraint and condition? So these are the domain you need to cover. What are the various type of tests? Routine test, type test, special test. There are so many tests, 10 to 15 tests which are associated with the transformer. You must be well aware. And what are the equipment used for testing? Very important questions. The second thing is, in machine and power system basically, you need to follow this cycle. Problem, cause, effect, solution. See, you have prepared these subjects very extensively for the written exam, right? But for interview, what you need to focus in your mind, what is the problem? Suppose voltage imbalance is the problem. Then what is the cause of that? And you know, if we have problem in system, then definitely there will be effect. What is the effect? Then what is the solution for that problem? So this four chain you need to cover in any of the machine. Start asking yourself question. Okay, this is the problem. Then what is the ultimate cause of that problem? Then what will be the effect of that problem? And what is the solution of that problem? If you will start preparing your machine and power system like this, na, you will find all the answer for the question which will be asked in the interview. Honestly, trust me. Second thing about machine efficiency, how you can reduce the machine losses. What are the different power loss area, where power is dissipated, how you can control those from the construction point of view, by the compensation point of view. What are the different motors and machine specifications? What are their electrical characteristics? How different electrical parameters and non-electrical parameters are varying with each other? You must be well aware of characteristics which are associated with the machines. They can ask you to draw the graph between any of the electrical or non-electrical parameters. So this is the area where you need to focus on the machine and keep this in mind. Problem, cause, effect, solution. If you found some problem, start asking yourself a question, what will be the cause? And because of that problem, what will be the effect? I say, sir, voltage deviation from the rated value is the problem. Then start finding what will be the cause. Or agar voltage deviation hota, uska kya effect hoga? Aur uska solution kya ho sakta? Kaise usko avoid kare? If you will start asking yourself these sort of the question while preparing, then your preparation will be very efficient. And prepare transformer in more detail. Then we talk about power system. Prepare and revise your notes which you have done once for the gate. Apart from that, give more focus towards the power flow control mechanism, power stability, transmission efficiency, voltage regulation, what are the different type of the compensation technique we can employ. The more question they will ask about the circuit breaker, isolator, fuses and relays and their specification and ratings. Then stability, transient stability, steady state stability, main area of concern in the interview. What are the design methods to improve the stability? When you are designing the transmission line, what are the transmission line design considerations so can we can avoid the losses and effect which practically occurs? How the various power system losses and effect are related to the dimension of conductor and surroundings and dielectric strength of the surroundings and related to the frequency of operation? What are the type of the fault, symmetrical fault, unsymmetrical fault? So these are the questions basically you need to explore into. Apart from which you have prepared for the gate. These are the areas you need to focus more. If I talk about the power device, the power supply is the one of the common question asked. What is the general arrangement of the UPS? Very common question. What are the different type of power supplies? What are the normal specification of the power supplies? And sometimes they ask the random question, you know, how you can test the power device with the multimeter? For example, try, test this with the multimeter. Tell the procedure, how you will do it? What are the desirable characteristics of any power device? What do you understand by the efficiency versus switching frequency curve? What information you get from that curve? What is the conclusion of that curve? Then what is the difference between the active switching device and passive switching device on the power device? Difference between the power device and the linear device or power diode and the signal diode? Which semiconductor we are using, silicon carbide or silicon? What are the comparison if we make two specimen by using silicon carbide and silicons? More question on the rating of the power device in terms of voltage, current and you know upper frequency cutoff. So these are the area you need to prepare apart from the gate, which most of the times you know student ignore. They focus more into you know whatever they have prepared for the gate. That is not sufficient. So keep in mind, right? So what should be the characteristics curve of the idle switching device? What are the various switching losses? And moreover, the applications of the power electronics in your career, whether your working experience, have you dealt with any of the applications? And second thing, you know, do you think, you know, how we can imply the controlling mechanism in the power electronics? What are the different controller we can employ? And third thing, very important, if you think you have done some project, sometimes they ask, you know, how you can control this project or this entire process which you have done by using the controller. General based question. See, they are not going to ask you very hardcore question on the basis of the numerical analysis and this all. Their question will be related to the industry orientations and practical. So if you are preparing for the interview, prepare the topic only on the basis of its applications, its specification, rating, and how more effective you can make that, and the comparison of the technologies and physical interpretation. That is why I already in the beginning mentioned that the preparation for interview is totally different from the written. Your approach should be totally different. And the way you will answer in the interview, that matters a lot. Approach play a very important role. So if you belong to electrical engineering, what should be your four subject? Any of the two core subject and any of the two engineering subjects, basic engineering subject, that is enough. Okay, if he's not satisfied, he will ask you any more, then you can add any additional subject. So I will suggest to people, whatever I have discussed in this video, apart from what you have prepared for GATE, focus more on this topic. And if you find any difficulty, you can connect us. Fine, thank you.